Well, good evening and welcome to our annual Christmas concert. It's always an exciting event, one that not only the school looks forward to, but community members, and it's beautiful weather outside, not cold enough, in my opinion, for a Christmas concert. But last night I had the, two nights ago, I was at the girls' varsity basketball game, and old friend Verl Kratzer, one of the first persons I met here when I moved to Kidron. I was sitting by myself. He came over and sat with me, and we were just talking about basketball and philosophizing, like, why is this important? What do they learn from this? Looks pretty stressful out there. What can be gleaned from this, especially from a Christian perspective? And so we talked about lessons of success, lessons of failure, discipline, all of those things. They were important. And I think the same parallel happens tonight. Why do we do this? Why do we get stressed? Why do we practice for so long? There's tons of good stuff that you're going to be witness to tonight. It's not going to be perfect. I got that monkey off my back a long time ago. But excellence doesn't mean perfect. And we always strive to be better, to do better. And music can be... The study of music can be a parallel for our own character, for our own lives, how we continually polish and try to perfect something. And so I hope you get more than just a beautiful concert tonight. But think about all those things, especially from the perspective of a young person mastering the craft of singing or playing an instrument. Really sad that the jazz band won't be able to play tonight. All the trumpets are sick. And a jazz band without trumpets is like a choir without sopranos. There's no melody. It's just, you don't even know what song they're singing. so we're actually going to start with the guitar class, and I'm hoping they're coming. Man, this is the annual concert comedy routine, isn't it? There they are. Come on out, John. Don't be shy. So there's John, Jacob. Then we got Jingle, AJ, Carson, Dela, and Christian. So the jazz band was going to play Angels We Have Heard on High, but they're not here, so we're going to play it. So, thank you.
Woodwinds are going to play two songs tonight. The first one being Celebrations for Christmas. The composer of that was talking about, I was reading, and he said, hey, it's so hard to do these same carols year after year and make them sound new. And I thought this was a great version of a number of carols that will be familiar to you all, but in a kind of new package. And then the second one we're doing is the First Noel with a kind of mix of some of Pachelbel's canon in there as well.
Thank you.
So it's been a few years since the orchestra has played Sleigh Ride, but we're going to do it again. Just a few minutes to reset the stage, and Nate may have something to say. A fellow Nate.
Yes. We met our Nate quota this year. You can bring the house lights up. It is an intermission, so if you did want to grab a quick comfort break in the restroom, that's completely acceptable. My name's Nate Holt. I'm the superintendent at Central, and many of you have been to many concerts already this year. My goal tonight is to sound less like an NPR or a PBS guy that's doing their end of year pitch. So I'll start with this right now, right? There was a wise man many, many years ago that said, give to Caesar what is Caesar and give to God what is God's. And for all of you out there that pay taxes, you're gonna get a handout that you can have for yourself. Take a couple extras that you can give to your neighbors, your friends, your family members, anybody in the state of Ohio, because there is a way to save money on your Ohio taxes, which is really, really good. and that money then comes dollar for dollar to Central Christian School. Okay, let me explain real quick. About 2 years ago, the state of Ohio did a donation tax credit, scholarship donation tax credit. And with that, provides an opportunity for every Ohio taxpayer, up to $750 per taxpayer, you can get a dollar for dollar credit. So that means if you owe taxes every year, you could go $750 less. If you're a couple, you file jointly, $1,500 less, okay? It seems too good to be true. We've got board members in the audience. I will be hanging out in the PAC lobby afterwards. I'd love to talk to you more about it. This is the third time you've heard me say it. We're about done with filing tax season 2023. It's a great time to make that contribution. Servant Partners is a 501c3. It's a nonprofit organization, and they have a scholarship granting organization. You can make your contribution to Servant Partners. That money, you will get a receipt. And so when you file your taxes for Ohio, that money that you contribute, up to $750, is coming right back to you. So if you get a nice little discount, or not, excuse me, a nice little refund from the state of Ohio, you'll get a little bit larger of a refund from the state of Ohio. And Servant Partners, dollar for dollar, gives that money back to Central Christian School. Okay? I want to be honest with you here. Many of the kids, I don't know if they know this, I'm a little bit of a recovering Scrooge. And it isn't because I'm just rolling in money and I'm a miser. That's not it at all. For whatever reason in my adult life, I'm just not this big Christmas guy. It is really hard not to just absolutely love Christmas at Central Christian. Laura Dudak decorates all of these trees and sets up for weeks to make our school look festive and great. Laura Dudak, Nate Gundy, Hannah Steiner, and Tim Chu are four of the most outstanding music teachers on the planet, and we get to have them every day. Lacey Teason and Joanne Summers Love are two of the finest art teachers, and make sure you take a moment to walk around and see the beautiful displays of our visual arts out there. Our fine arts, we talk about being distinctive, but you and I both know what we've just experienced for the last 40 minutes is evidence of that, and what we're about to experience in the next half hour, 40 minutes, is evidence of that too. That tax credit comes back to Central, and we can continue to provide a high quality education that is centered on Christ Jesus. And I am so passionate about doing that. We grow Christian leaders that follow Jesus. They're well-rounded. They're young people that have learned how to think and grow and to serve. And the way that they're living here in this space is, I believe, going to transform our communities here over the next several years. I'm just so thankful for that. So what I'm trying to pitch you on in these handouts are, take a look at it. If you have questions, please let me know. Talk to one of our board members that's in the audience. We even have a few board members from Servant Partners in the audience tonight too. So you can check out some videos on our website or our YouTube page. I can't be more urgent about some of the amazing things that could happen if our community makes this a regular habit here, taking advantage of that tax credit in many, many ways. I want to tell you about a couple other things that are coming up. Next Friday is alumni night. So if you are a Central Christian alum, admissions on the school, come in, enjoy some basketball games. There'll be some giveaways, which is kind of fun, but it's more just another opportunity for all of us to be together and celebrate some of the things that we've got going on in our athletic program. We are really excited too about a nice break. Can I get an amen? Down the front, yeah? All right. We're looking forward to a nice little break. But when we come back, for the first time in Central Christian history, our mini-term program is expanding. Our elementary, from kindergarten all the way through 12th grade this year, are going to have a mini-term experience, and we are so excited about the opportunities that our students will have with that. I am so blessed to be here in this audience with you. I am so thankful to look at these wonderful human beings that you entrust us with every single day, and we're grateful for that. For those of you that are listening online, we're grateful that you're tuning in as well. And appreciate the beauty of the music program tonight. Let's put our hands together and welcome Tim Hsu and the chorale back to the stage.
Can you turn the house lights off? We get stage fright when we see people looking at us.
These are a few of my favorite things. freshman sophomore corral. You can stand and come to the stage. I think it's so important, and I too often forget, to thank the people that make songs possible, like Hannah Steiner over here. The choir can know all their parts, and it can be perfect, but without that one person, it doesn't happen. And later you'll hear Naomi Himes. And so be sure and thank the accompanists at your church or wherever. Hannah Himes is our soloist for our next piece, Jesus, What a Wonderful Child.
Jesus.
This next piece is an arrangement based on a tune from 1582 called Gaudete, and it's one we performed at our recent Madrigal feast, and it's fun to go back in time, like centuries worth of time, and kind of get a glimpse of what music might have sounded like back then. Stephen Hatfield wrote some additional verses to this piece, so it's 1582 and 2002. Mashed together.
Christus is not to sex, Maria Virgine. Gaudete, Gaudete, Christus is not to sex, Maria Virgine.
And our next piece is one that we learned specifically for the Madrigal Feast. You can't sing it in too many places. You'll soon find out that it was perfect for a big feast like we had. And it's kind of a shame that it's kind of comical because the music is so good. So this is Banquet Fugue.
Guzzle, 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 munch, munch, gobble, gobble, chomp, pass the salt and the pepper and the mustard.
Guzzle, 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 munch, munch, gobble, gobble, chomp, pass the salt and the pepper and the mustard.
Guzzle,
guzzle, guzzle,
the salt,
munch, munch, gobble, gobble, chomp,
pass the salt and the pepper and the mustard.
Pass the salt and the pepper.
Thank you.
The jester's in this choir too, so there's a little bit of a wardrobe transition, shall we say. I gotta hand it to concert choir. You're gonna love this next piece. It's called Babe of Bethlehem. It's one I learned when I sang with the Summit Choral Society 30 years ago. We sang it up there as a professional choir. And I've only done it 3 times here at Central. And it has to be the right combination of people that are ambitious enough to tackle a crazy hard challenge and then actually do it. It's pretty cool. It's an early American hymn tune, and as was the tradition, those early American tunes went on and on and on. And if you go to original sources, you can find, 15, 20 verses. We're gonna stop at 8 tonight for you. But that reduces down to still 20 pages of really challenging music. So, you guys ready back there? Yeah? Okay, come on. And again, the accompaniment for this also took some considerable work from Naomi.
Nations, all of you I call, come hear this declaration, and don't refuse this glorious news of Jesus and salvation. To royal Jews came first the news of Christ the great Messiah, as was foretold by prophets old, Isaiah, Jeremiah.
We do appear good news to bear, as now we will inform.
Our next piece will have a kind of the same character as the first song that we did. It's also an early American Christmas tune, and it's one that we will be performing with 10 other schools at Goshen College this spring as we go to our annual choir festival and team up with our sister schools from all over North America. And lost a couple fiddles. Fiddlesticks. There they are. So it's Harper Hsu and Aaron Meidel playing the violin parts for Brightest and Best, and again Naomi on the piano. We didn't need words. Do that in a game. Get a little crazy up here. We're gonna have all the chorale boys. You can come to the stage for a Christmas song from Nigeria.
Thank you.
we see a new face at the piano over here. So Hannah Steiner will be playing with piano with John Weirich over here. This is called Piano for Four Hands. So there's a lot of action going on. So you might know John as the local pharmacist down there, but he's also a musician extraordinaire. He just came from Sonnenberg Village playing with the Orville Band, rushed over here. So appreciate that, John. And after this, you are, I guess you're dismissed. We'll turn the lights on and we want to meet you in the lobby afterward. So thanks so much for coming. You can turn the house lights on back there, and thanks for coming. Good night, and Merry Christmas.